Hello, in this video we are gonna use the horizontal container to do our first use of the container in a practical situation. We are gonna get these labels that are supposed to be the header of the gallery and make them distribute equally through the screen based, it doesn't matter the size, the width of the screen, so it will auto adapt, it will be responsive. Okay, let's go and insert a horizontal container. If you don't know what it is, look at the previous video in this playlist because I explained a little bit. Now we saw the theory, let's see the practice. I'm going to insert a horizontal container. So horizontal container. Let me just resize it a little bit. And let me put here in the bottom because the other things are here. Just resize maybe the gallery, then move this down, and I can put the container back to the top. It's better in the top, right? Okay. Let's get these labels here, cut them, and paste inside the container. So I'm going to select all of them, pressing Shift and clicking. Then I'm going to press Ctrl X or clicking the right button and click on Cut. And I'm going to click in the container, right click, paste, and the labels are going to be pasted inside the container. Okay, now we can see that it's a horizontal container. The labels are in the top, aligned in the top, because in the configuration here the vertical align is in the top. We could have in the middle, in the center, or make them stretch to occupy the full size of the container. We don't see any difference, but they stretched if we click in the individual ones. Okay, let's keep in the middle. Maybe it's better to see how the labels are distributed if we give some background color to the labels. So usually when you want to differentiate things in the screen, you just put some background colors temporarily so you can see them better. I will select all the labels and change the color here, the background color, to this light blue color. Then we can see the labels better. And we can, of course, now make it stretch and see the difference, okay? Just keep in the middle. We see, for example, that the labels are... the sum of the width of the labels is bigger than the container because the class label is missing a part. See, if we decrease the container, it gets even worse, but if I increase the container, I see that I have a blank space here. And in order to make them to just adapt, distribute evenly, we could just select all the labels and mark here the flexible width. And they are all just going to adapt. So if I resize the container, they are going to adapt together with the container. But notice that there is one point here, that when I decrease the container, it doesn't do anymore. That's because once I selected the flexible width for the labels, let me select one of them, for example, and if I check here, I have a minimum width parameter. So it means that when the size of the container is smaller, the label will keep 150 pixels width. If I want to make them shrink even more, I can select all the labels and change to 100, for example, or 50. Oops, I just put a big number, 50. See, they are just going to adapt until it gets to 50, and then it will stop decreasing the width automatically. Okay, so this will make them adapt in the same size as the container. If we want to put some space between them, between all of them, we can just put a gap here. Let's say one. It will just put a very small gap in the labels. We could put, for example, 16, a bigger gap. And that will do automatically in the middle of all the elements that I have inside my container. Okay, so we have something that already adapts automatically. If I play the app, remember that two videos ago, or in the previous video, I think, I disabled the scale to fit, so the app takes the full width of the screen. And now I also want that this container takes the full width of the screen together with the app. Okay, in order to do that, we just need to play with some parameters, the position and the size of the container. Okay, so first thing, I want the container to be in the very left, so the X of the container will be 0, so it starts when the screen starts. And to make the container occupy the full width of the screen, we need to tell the container that its width will be the same as the screen. So we are going to click here in the width property, or select the width property here in the formula bar for the container. And instead of having a fixed value, let's make it have the same width as the screen. In this case, as the parent of the container. The screen is the parent of the container because the container is inside the screen. Okay, this is a concept we use a lot to refer to the width and height of the parent control. For example, this first label, what's the parent of this label? Is the container 11 because it's directly inside the container. If we look at the gallery, for example, this image, what's the parent of the image? Is the gallery because the image is inside the gallery. And the parent of the gallery is the screen. So we refer a lot to this parent property. If I click in the container and I tell that the width is parent.width, I will tell the container to have the same width as the screen. So now if I play the app, I see that the container occupies the width of the screen, and if I resize the screen, the container will also resize its size. Look, so it's being responsive to the size of the screen. Okay, here I'm not liking that this label is too to the left, too much to the left, and same too much to the right. There is no border here. We can easily do selecting the container. And we have the padding options here, the padding left, for example, let's say 16, and also the right 16, it will make the labels go a little more to the center, and that distance between the labels will change automatically. So that's a very good thing for the container. It does a lot of stuff automatically. Okay, so let's pay attention that we have a formula in the width property, but if by any reason we resize the container, it will lose that formula and put a fixed number again. So once you set a formula, try not to drag things again because they are going to lose that reference. Let's put back the width as parent.width. In the Y, I'll put 0, so like it was in the top. And I'm going to do the same for the gallery right now. So if I put the gallery here below this header, I can make the gallery occupy the height and the width of the page. And since my page is stretching to the same size as the browser, it won't work very well because once I hit play, the screen will increase its size and height. And the gallery will keep the same width and height because it's not dynamic. So I need to go and play with the properties width and height. Let's do. So let's select the gallery. In the width, let's use the same formula as the container. So parent.width. Here I'm just going to change the background of the gallery so we can see it working. Same way as we did with the labels. Let's put this light blue. And then if I hit play, I can see that the gallery occupied the full width. Not the high yet. It seems to be occupying the same high, but if, for example, I decrease the zoom of the screen, I can see that the high now of the page is higher and the gallery is not stretching. So in this case, we need to put the formula in the high of the gallery too. So in this case, it's going to be parent.height. Let's select the gallery and let me just recover the zoom. In the height, let's put parent.height so the gallery will have the same height as the screen. Now, if I remove the zoom, we can see that the gallery is occupying the full size of the page, but there is still one thing, because I put the gallery to have the same height as the page, but actually we don't want that, because the gallery already starts in the position 97, that's the Y of the gallery. So in this case, the gallery is being bigger than the screen. And if we had the gallery full of items, we might lose some items in the end that are going to be outside of the vision of the user. So instead of having the same height as the parent, we need to remove that part that's being occupied by the container 11. So in this case, we could do parent.height less than minus container 11.height. And then it will occupy the full space, the full remaining space in the screen that the gallery can take. Okay? We didn't need to do these formulas if we were using more containers, a combination of containers. And we are going to see this in the next video. We are going to take this to the next level, making it look like this one that I have in this screen, where we have a container here, a gallery, and both are inside a vertical container. So they are going to adapt automatically. And I didn't need to worry about the formulas in the height of the gallery to make it adapt, because it can stretch to the size of the container. So in the next video, we are going to do exactly that and have it formatted, as we just saw here, occupying the full screen. Okay, so see you in the next video. I will leave the link right now for you to keep watching.